everyone. Thank you for coming out this morning. My name is Troy Brown. I'm the city manager of the city of Tracy. You can go ahead and relax for a minute. I'm just going to give you a sense about how the morning will flow and introduce some dignitaries that are here. Today, the mayor will speak regarding some issues related to EMS, followed by our fire chief, and then we'll have a resident speak, but I'll get into greater detail with that. I want to introduce a couple of dignitaries that are here with us, in addition to the folks that are up here. We have Mayor Pro Tem Veronica Vargas with us this morning, as well as Council Member Rhodesia Ransom. To my right, I have Tracy Mayor Robert Rickman, that is R-I-C-K-M-A-N. To his right, we have Fire Chief Randy Bradley, that is B-R-A-D-L-E-Y. And to his right, we have Tracy resident Alice English, that is E-N-G-L-I-S-H. We also have our police chief here, Larry Esquivel, and we're flanked with the brave men of the Tracy Fire Department. Today, the mayor will speak. As I mentioned, Chief Bradley will speak, and then Ms. English will speak relative to issues related to emergency services here in the city. Following that, Chief Bradley will facilitate a question and answer session among the media for those that have questions. But today, we're going to be discussing emergency medical calls within the city of Tracy. Each county in California has a local emergency medical services administrator, or LEMSA, that, among other things, establishes protocols for local agencies, special districts, and private ambulance companies on how to respond to emergency medical calls. The city of Tracy is certified through the San Joaquin County LEMSA as an advanced life support agency, and as such, has paramedics in each of its fire stations 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Last year, it was brought to light that although paramedics are dispatched to the vast majority of medical emergencies, paramedics are not being dispatched to every medical call within the city, even though the city has the resources and capacity to do so. That prompted a conversation and negotiation with the LEMSA to allow the city to exercise its local control in responding to all medical emergencies. Those negotiations are ongoing. However, they have not yet been completed. I am now going to turn it over to Mayor Rickman, who will provide some comments relative to this issue.
I want to thank everybody here today for joining us for the press conference. And today I would like to address the media on a serious issue that's affecting the health and safety of our community, and that's our inability to respond to all medical emergencies. In Tracy, due to an existing San Joaquin County policy, EMS policy 3202, this policy prevents the Tracy Fire Department and the South County Fire Authority from responding to all emergency medical calls in our community, even when there aren't ambulances available in Tracy. And yes, you know, I said that correctly. There are times when there's not one ambulance in the city of Tracy, a city of 90,000 people. There is a serious flaw in the protocol the San Joaquin County EMS agency uses to determine if Tracy Fire is dispatched to a call. These flaws have resulted in the Tracy Fire Department not being dispatched to serious medical emergencies or greatly increased our response time by delaying or the dispatching, which may have resulted in the loss of two lives, one in 2016 and one just 2 weeks ago. And these are just the ones that we know about. On Easter of last year, a member of this community passed away while waiting approximately 19 minutes for an ambulance. The elderly lady was having trouble breathing, and the nursing facility called 911. An ambulance was dispatched, but not our fire department. Approximately 10 minutes later, the elderly lady stopped breathing, and 911 was called for a second time. At this time, our fire department was finally dispatched. It took the ambulance, like I said before, approximately 19 minutes to arrive. The reason for the delay of the ambulance was that there was no ambulance available in the city of Tracy, and they had to respond from Manteca. We have a fire station approximately a mile and a half away from this incident. The lady sadly ended up passing away. Another incident occurred on April 29th of this year, when a man underwent cardiac arrest, and it took approximately 18 minutes for an ambulance to arrive. Had our fire department been dispatched to the incident as soon as the call came in, they would have arrived in approximately 5 minutes and begin resuscitation. Our fire station is approximately 4 miles away from this incident. And sadly, this man ended up passing away. There are several other emergency incidents, medical incidents that have taken place, and our fire chief, Randall Bradley, will address those momentarily. No community should ever have to experience this. No resident ever should ever have to wonder whether or not help will arrive in time to save their life or a life of one of their loved ones. But that is what we are experiencing in Tracy. The Tracy Fire Department has the trained personnel, the paramedics, the equipment, the capacity, and the public expectation to respond to all medical emergencies within our jurisdiction. The county EMS director administers this policy, and he makes a decision when our fire department will respond. We have been talking to the county for over a year about these incidents and the effect it has had and continues to have on our community. As of today, we are still not allowed to respond to all emergency medical calls and continue to negotiate with the county to amend this policy. Our county supervisor, Bob Ellis, supports Tracy and our efforts to change this policy. How many people have to suffer or die under this policy before action is taken to do the right thing? We should not be playing politics with people's lives. A resolution needs to happen now. When a medical emergency exists, seconds and minutes can mean the difference between life and death. As the mayor of Tracy and speaking on behalf of the council, we are concerned for the safety of our community, and that is why we're here. As a husband and a father of two teenage daughters, I'm concerned, God forbid, if something that would happen to my daughters under this current policy, how long would it take for help to arrive? This policy, 3202, is immoral, unethical, and unacceptable. It is unacceptable to our council, and most of all, it's unacceptable to our community. This policy must be changed, and this council will do all that it can to ensure our residents and visitors that they have the best emergency medical services available. And we will not stop fighting to gain local control over our resources until this is resolved. Now, common sense must prevail on this. So I ask here today, the county EMS director, let's come together for the health and safety of our community. Let's put lives before the politics and let our firefighters do what they do best, and that's to save lives. Now I would like to welcome our fire department, or our fire chief, Randy Bradley, to the podium. So thank you.
Good morning. My name is Randall Bradley, and I'm the fire chief of the Tracy Fire Department of South County Fire Authority. I'd first like to thank you all for being here, and also I would like to thank our city council and Mayor Rickman for understanding the importance of this issue and to stepping up and working hard with the fire department and the county to resolve this and to protect the community. They've always made public safety their number one priority, and today's press conference represents that commitment to public safety in our community. As a fire chief, I'm extremely frustrated. I'm the only fire chief in the United States, okay, that we know of that is negotiating with a county bureaucrat who is not a doctor, who is not a nurse, and who has never been a paramedic on my ability to send my firefighters to protect our public and to serve as our safety net for our community. And I have to tell you, that is unacceptable. And the protocols that have been placed on the city of Tracy are urban protocols that the cities of Stockton and Oakland need because they do not have the resources to respond to emergencies. We have the capacity, we have the desire, we have the funding, to protect our community, and we should be responding to all emergencies. We know that several low-level emergencies are actually under-categorized or under-triaged, and those low-level emergencies turn in to significant emergencies. And when they do, a fire engine that's close by with a paramedic should respond and serve as a safety net for those emergencies. And that's all that we've asked for. The reason that we've been given by the county that we cannot respond to emergencies has been things like, we can't allow you to get there first because that would make us look bad when our ambulances were delayed in responding. That is not an acceptable answer. Another answer is, when somebody dies in your community, it's an anomaly, okay? A death is never an anomaly. We need to be able to respond and protect our community. I've been told that the policy is a good policy. There's nothing wrong with the policy. And I could give you several examples of people who have laid in warehouses and suffered with broken femurs, with lacerated legs, with babies in cars, two-year-olds, that had febrile seizures, that were in hot cars waiting alongside of the freeway 30 minutes for an ambulance without a fire department response. That is unacceptable to this community. And we will keep fighting to ensure that you're protected, and that we understand, and that the Board of Supervisors understand, that this is Tracy. It's not Oakland, it's not Stockton. And we expect greater service levels from our fire department, and we expect that we'll be able to respond to all emergencies. We continue in negotiations with the county, and we're hoping that the county understands the importance of allowing the Tracy Fire Department to respond to all medical emergencies within our jurisdictional boundaries. And that will conclude my comments at this time.
Thank you, Chief Bradley. Thank you, Mayor Rickman. They pretty much sum it up why we're here. As a concerned resident, back on April 4th, we went to City Council to let them know that it's been a year. But had that happened, when we went to the City Council, we were made aware of this two-year-old suffering on the side of the road. They called 911, and the ambulance was coming from Stockton. This is unacceptable. Our fire department was not dispatched. We were lucky that our fire department came upon this incident. Can you imagine anybody here holding on to your child for more than 3 minutes, waiting to see what's happening? This is unacceptable. This is why we're involved. We are lucky that we have residents. Domingo, I don't know where you're at, but we've so far gathered a little over 3,000 signatures. Why does it have to come to this point? Why do we have to be here? That's the question everybody should be asking. Everybody should be appalled at what's going on here. When there's a victim that's being shot, it's on the news. It's on the news. People are dying. People are suffering. 20, 30, 35 minutes. Why? My granddaughter has a nut allergy. Heaven forbid that something would happen because our fire department was not dispatched, because they did not put that as a priority. All we're asking from the county to change this policy to allow our trained paramedics to be dispatched. That's what they're for. Everyone in this country, that's our safety net. They're our first responders. They're trained for this. Like Chief Bradley and our mayor said, they're our safety net. Who is this guy taking our safety net away from us? Why is he playing Russian roulette with our lives? It is a Russian roulette. Who's next? I said this 3 weeks ago. Unfortunately, it was Tracy. It was Tracy. And that's sad that somebody had to die. Have we been able to respond, our fire department? Could have they have saved his life? We will never know. We will never know. And I've gotten stories from so many people that I am not able to release yet because I want to get concrete information. There's two other people that's possibly died because our fire department was not dispatched. And the fire department was literally down the street, not even a mile away. It's unacceptable. And what I'm saying is we should not have to be here for this. We have our armed forces right now dying, protecting this country for our safety. Who's protecting us here in this county? This shouldn't happen. It should not happen. Not in the United States of America. One person dictating to our board of supervisors what calls our fire department could respond. Could you imagine if somebody put that restriction on our police department? Sorry, can't go to this one. No, it should be our fire department to tell us when our fire department could go in there or not if the situation's not secure. That should be the only person. I hope our board of supervisors get this going as soon as possible. We should not have one more life. We should not have another child. The one from that had the seizure on the side of the road was told that the ambulance was coming. I still can't believe that it was coming from Stockton. And a week after that was another child. And then a few months before that, it was a basketball coach, a 69-year-old basketball coach, breathing, needed CPR. And our fire department was about a mile away, was not dispatched until almost 12 minutes into the call. A mile away. Why does this have to happen in our city? Why does this have to happen in the United States? I'm appalled and I'm surprised that this has not been taken care of. It bothers me more than anything that we even have to be here for this. My child, my grandchild, my friend or neighbor, Paula Bonca, she's a bleeder. Can you imagine if the fire department is not gonna be dispatched until 10 minutes into the call while AMR is on its way? She would die. She takes care of children. She has a daycare center. Heaven forbid that something would happen to the child, a child provider taking care of our children. This doesn't not only affect Tracy. There's people here in Tracy from Manteca, Lathrop, and Stockton working in Tracy, people visiting Tracy. Hope it does not happen again. I'm so upset that this has to continue. We will continue going forward with our signatures. We will continue going and knocking doors if we need to. Should we have to? Should we have to? Another thing that surprises me is that many, many people in Tracy still don't know about this absurd policy that we have. This guy is taking our safety net away, our lifeline. Nowhere in this country that our fire departments are not given that opportunity to save a life or to help somebody that's seriously injured. I could go on and on and on, but I do have stories here. Most important, a lot of people don't know until today, I've gotten 3 or 4 pages of emails with people ready to go to the Board of Supervisors with their stories. I was on the phone late last night with another death that I would have to look into that our fire department was not dispatched. And they think they're the only ones. They think they're the only ones that this happened to. Sadly, it's not. So I really thank everybody. I want to thank all the city residents that have been supporting us, helping us out there. And also, too, what's more important is the staff working hard on this. And I understand the frustration of Chief Bradley and our mayor that this is going on. They're not taking our city council serious. They're not. They're not taking our city council serious. This is why it's being dragged. We're negotiating? Negotiating to what? Another death? Another child? Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you, Chief Bradley. I get too emotional when it comes to life and death.
Thank you. You're doing great. Okay, at this time, I'll take questions from either the press or even from the audience.
Chief, so when I last spoke with Dan Burke, the administrator, on May 2nd, he said that he's still waiting for the city to grant the county access to dispatch data and access to all the...
Yes, and that's a request that came kind of late in the negotiations, and we understand that. They're well aware that we don't have the capability today to provide that access to that information that they've asked for. We've, provided a smaller set of data that we could provide with a commitment to get that data to them at some point. We do see that request as a little bit of a red herring argument, and that it seems like every time we address another issue that they have, they come up with something else. So we're extremely frustrated. And what frustrates us the most is the only thing that we really can come up with, that the real reason we can't respond to emergencies, is they're protecting the interest of the private ambulance company. And that, and if that's the case, we're the city of Tracy, and we believe that we should have a local control responsibility to provide the best service levels that our community expect. Another question?
What about as far as county policy, you know, throughout the county, what about the other cities as far as Stockton, Rhode Island?
I think that's a great question, and Stockton's a great fire department. Because they're an urban fire department, they do not have the capacity to respond to these lower level calls. At some point, they hope to get their staffing levels back up to the point where they do have that capacity, and the chief of Stockton is very supportive of our efforts to be able to respond to all emergencies.
But aren't they responding to some of these 911 calls?
No, they absolutely responding to most of the 911 calls, but it's the lower level calls they're not responding to that we want to respond to, because we know a certain percentage of those calls are more severe than the dispatch realizes.
But several years ago, I think there was a dispute between the county
absolutely.
And the city, because the city was trying to get its own ambulance service for the EMTs, and it had to expand later on.
Right, right. And so a little bit of this is a fallout of that lawsuit. We've been told a couple of times that they won that lawsuit, therefore, they don't even have to consider allowing us to respond to additional emergencies. So yeah, a little bit of that is connected directly to the lawsuit, and Stockton actually entered into a settlement agreement with the county, and some of those requirements in that settlement agreement actually impacts this policy 3202.
And Chief, when you spoke a little bit more than a month ago, you seemed hopeful.
Yeah, well, our mayor and our supervisor that represents this community actually sat down in the negotiations and pretty much gave pretty clear direction that this thing had to be done by May 1st. And then it was obvious it wasn't going to get done by May 1st. And then we had another death on April 29th. And then we still had hoped that this week we could come to some resolution on this issue, and it didn't occur. So while we're still in negotiations, it seems like they throw up additional roadblocks as we go through the negotiations. So
that's my question, Chief. How long could this change in policy take? How long should it take?
The change in policy could become effective immediately. Really, it would take about 2 hours for them to reprogram their computer-aided dispatch system, and so it could go into effect immediately. There's just a reluctance to do that, and we're still not extremely clear what the reluctance is. We're guessing these lower-level emergencies. Again, they don't provide the data to us, so we really don't even know the number of emergencies we're missing in our community. But we're guessing anywhere between 3 or 4 emergencies a day that are the lower level emergencies, and maybe 10% of those, we estimate about 10% of those turn into more significant emergencies. So those are the ones we're looking at trying to be the safety net and to capture. Yes?
Yeah, 3 paramedic rigs assigned to Tracy through AMR. Is that correct?
In the county contract, contract lists 3 paramedic ambulances that should be assigned to Tracy 24/7, 365. Yes.
Assigned doesn't mean in district. You have 7 engine companies with EMTs and paramedics that are available.
That's correct.
And they're being precluded from responding to calls because when someone dials 911, it goes to an AMR call center. And they decide whether or not they're going to advise the Tracy Fire Department. Is that correct?
That's correct.
So essentially, the citizens are paying for paramedic and EMT services through the fire department, and AMR, a for-profit company, is allowed to screen calls and decide whether or not we as citizens are going to receive service.
That's correct, but I do want to clarify, they do use protocols in order to do that, and it is monitored. We disagree with how the protocol is being used in the suburban environment. That's true. Are there any other questions? Yes.
I think more of a solution. When you dial 911, you say fire first.
We do not recommend you. I've heard that before. We want the 911 system to work the way it's supposed to work. We still encourage everyone to dial 911. and to give the correct information. That's very important. We need to fix it at this level and not try to circumvent the system. Okay, well, thank you. I really appreciate everybody's time.
Can I add something real quick? I just want to add something on the question about the Stockton Fire Department lawsuit, and that was about transport, correct?
Yes,
and I just want to make sure everybody understands, we're not asking to transport people. All we're asking is to respond, you know, to help somebody out and to provide medical service. The faster we respond to a scene and provide medical treatment, the faster that party can be transported also. So I just wanted to make sure people understand that. This is about responding to a medical call, not transporting, and our ambulance company that serves this area would still have the main responsibility of transporting. And I also want to add also that these three or four calls that our chief just talked about doesn't cost the City of Tracy anything. We have the resources now that they could do it today. It doesn't cost the county a dime for us to use our own resources. Yes, ma'am.
So is there any suggestion that the county would want to charge us to provide the service that we're already saying we're equipped and capable of providing?
No. I just wanted to clarify that. So thank you, and appreciate everybody coming. And it's a very serious issue that I hope we get rectified very, very quickly. So thank you very much. Have a great morning and afternoon.